Yeah? Can I help you? No problem? So I've left that situation before it escalated with the painter and decorator, but let's review what he was up to. So obviously he's removed the two front screws out the socket outlet and lifted it away from the wall, allowing him to paint neatly around the actual socket outlet itself. We know that socket outlet was live because he was listening to his music, a situation that's unacceptable. There must be a solution to that problem, and we'll come up with that during this video presentation. But what is the risk? Well, there's a massive risk of electric shock from accessing the terminals in the back of the socket outlet. So that can't be left in situ, and there must be a solution to that problem. The solution for us to that problem is the Sockitz shield. This is the safety shield that goes on single and twin outlets. Let's review other situations similar to the painter's one that could also arise to a risk of electric shock. So looking at this one, you can see the socket outlet again has been removed from the wall, but this time in order to allow the plastering team to skim around the actual socket box itself. However, from the photograph, you can see that a lot of the plaster debris has fallen into that socket outlet and therefore is unacceptable. We cannot tell from the picture whether it's live or not, but we would like to leave the situation where a wall could be plastered, could be tiled, and could be energized, and we'll look at how the safety shield allows you to do that. The reason the electrical accessory can be energised in this picture is because it complies with BS 5733, which is the standard for electrical enclosures. It also complies with regulation 522.4.1 for the ingress protection. In other words, the IP rating of the enclosure has been restored by installing the shield. These safety socket shields also conform to BS 4662, which is for the standard sizes in the UK for single and twin boxes. What does this mean to the electrical contractor? Well, it means he can install his first and second fix, test the electrical circuits and energize them, leaving the safety shield in place. Coming back some days later, the plastering and painting and decorating team can complete their tasks before the requirement to de-energize the circuit, remove the safety shield and replace the socket fronts, meaning that all trades can work safely using the outlets that are in the installation, such as lighting and sockets, in order to aid their job, but also with zero risk of electric shock from actually touching the live parts behind the electrical enclosure. So let's take a closer look at the socket safety shield. They come in two different types, so the one and two gang, so I've got the two gang in front of me, and two different designs. They come as disposable and reusable. Let's have a look at the reusable one first. The reusable one separates in the corner, and it's going to separate in either corner, but in order to install it, you only need to separate into one of those corners. So we can do like so. If we open it out around my conductors like so, rejoin it back together and sit it into the position on top of the box like so. The disposable one. Now you're going to be thinking Gary's going to have to disconnect all the conductors in order to install the disposable one. You don't. Let's remove the plug itself from here, and then let's take this one back off. I haven't joined the corner, so make it easier for me to take it back off like so. And then we take one of the disposable ones. So we just need to slide it on. So as long as the conductors are nice and close in the back, we just slide it around the back and into position like so. And then obviously we can put our front back on it. Just to remind you, we would just break this little split here in order that we can take it off. So when we come to take it off at the end of the fix, we just crack it down here and it will part into two pieces. Very easy. When I say it's disposable, when you've used it, you should recycle it. It's actually made from the most recyclable plastic material that is out there. So we're not chucking these into a landfill when we're finished. We're actually going to recycle the material. I think it's time to pop upstairs and install one for our painter and decorator. So there was an easy solution to the situation the painter and decorator was facing with himself. He wanted to keep the stereo going. He obviously wanted to cut a nice paint line around here. He's removed the socket outlet and it's energized. We've de-energized the socket outlet now, and we're going to fit the Sockitz shield. We're going to fit the reusable type, ones that can go in each corner, both corners detached. You only need to detach one corner, go around the actual electrical accessory, which is isolated, reassemble the shield and locate it into the box itself. You cannot return the 3.5 machine screws you had with it because they're now not long enough. So temporarily, we're going to use some that are 50 mil long in order to put this outlet back. So let's do that next.
So if I just locate that one this side, like so, and I'm going to locate this one as well, and then we can just tighten them up. So what this will do will mean that we can re-energise the socket outlet safely, and we've returned the IP rating of all sides of the enclosure back to its original value. So let's screw this back into place, like so. Okay, and then this one. And what we've now is achieved the IP rating on the top surface to be a minimum of IP4X, and the remaining parts of the surface being a minimum of IP2X, meaning that now we can re-energise this socket outlet, we can paint round it, plaster round it, tile round it, whatever we're doing. So I've removed the safe isolation kit, I'm going to re-energise the circuit, it's back on, Gaz! The socket outlet is re-energised, so we can hear the music.